Today we're going to make a workbench. This video is sponsored by University of Phoenix. I'll tell you why I decided to become a student again a little bit later. Most of the workbenches that I have seen have been focused on a particular craft, like woodworking. My making experiments involve all sorts of different materials, so I needed more of a general purpose workbench that's super heavy duty. I selected 2.5 inch steel angles to make the base out of. I find that angles are a little bit easier to clamp things to than square tube. I cut the pieces to length using my abrasive cutoff saw. A couple of the pieces weren't quite even, so I just clamped them together and used my angle grinder to grind them down flush. I welded the end frames together first. I used my magnet clamps to hold the pieces in place. I then used these all-steel heavy-duty T-bar clamps from MakerBrand to pull the angles together so I could weld the top pieces. I then flipped the frame over and welded from the backside. Now I'm going to have to attach additional beams to the inside of these frames, so I had to grind the welds down nice and flush. I assembled the base upside down. I laid out the support beams and then propped up the frames on either end. I tacked on a few welds just to hold everything in place, and then used a ratchet strap, a 2x4, and some magnet clamps to position the other support beams. I also added some additional horizontal supports in between the support beams. I started by welding the inside edges of the steel angles before coming in from the other side and reinforcing all of the connections. I used some 1¼ by 1/8 inch steel angles to make a middle shelf that I'm going to use to hold the steel top. The sun is pretty intense out here in the desert, so I broke out the mullet hat again. The bench top is going to be made out of a bunch of 2x4s, so I started by trimming off the rounded edges with my table saw. I just trimmed off a little bit more than 1/4 inch on either side. I then took 7 of these trimmed 2x4s and started to glue them together. Now these 2x4s are pretty warped, so I used steel channels as coal boards and... Now remember the clamps I mentioned before? That's actually a company that I started with my friends Mike Montgomery from Modern Builds and Chris Salamone from Four Eyes Furniture. In addition to hosting a podcast together, we have also decided to start a tool company that focuses on the type of general making tools that we find very useful. The company is called MakerBrand, and our first product are these T-bar heavy-duty clamps. These clamps are all steel and super strong. There are zero plastic involved. We wanted a design that would have positive stops and a whole lot of travel in the screw mechanism. Cheap discount clamps often have aluminum bars which can twist and distort when you really apply a lot of pressure. Expensive parallel clamps are really nice, but they don't have that much travel in the screw mechanism, and they don't have positive stops. They also don't have perpendicular handles, which limits the amount of pressure you can apply with them. Our goal with MakerBrand is to identify some of the gaps in the market and provide high quality tools for general makers like us. Launching a tool company is no small task, and I don't have a business background. My education is in architecture and design. So I decided to become a student again and take a class at the University of Phoenix, which is the sponsor for this video. I enrolled in MGT 411, Innovative and Creative Business Thinking. As of now, I'm in the second week of this 5-week course, and it's great. The readings have been very insightful, and the class activities make sure that I'm held accountable and I'm actually doing them. Starting a new business is always risky, so taking classes like this help me feel like I'm protecting my time and my money that I'm investing into these new enterprises. This 5-week online class discusses innovation and creative thinking within the pursuit of generating revenue and building a business. I'm super excited about adding to my intellectual toolbox so that I'm better equipped to sell tools that you can put in your actual toolbox. Now, I'll be live blogging my experience with this course on Instagram, so be sure to follow me there and check that out. If you want to learn more, click on the links in the description box below. All right, back to the workbench. So I let the glue cure for 24 hours before gluing together the second piece of the bench top. This initial glue up will consist of 3 pieces, 2 pieces that are 10.5 inches wide, and a third piece that's 6 inches wide. I kept the pieces narrow and didn't glue them all together at once because I wanted to be able to run them through the thickness planer. I ran them through about 4 times on each side just to even out the edges. I then glued and clamped one of the 10.5 inch pieces to the 6 inch wide piece. I trimmed the bench tops with my circular saw, but the blade didn't quite go all the way through, so I had to finish off the cuts with my Japanese pull saw. I sanded the slabs with my orbital sander and took advantage of this new Ryobi vacuum box. I finished the wood with 3 coats of Minwax wipe-on poly. Now, whenever I go to a steel yard, I always like to look in the discount bin for cool-looking cutoffs. I cut the piece down to about 3.5 feet long using my angle grinder. I got this piece for pretty cheap, but it was quite rusted since it had been left outside, so I had to put in some work with the angle grinder and a flap disc. I cleaned the steel with acetone and then sealed it with some paste wax. I used construction adhesive to glue a piece of MDF to the inside of the channel. This will create room for my fingers when I move it from the lower shelf to the bench top. I drilled a bunch of holes through the angle sections of the frame so that I can install the shelves. Cleaned the base with acetone, and then sealed it with paste wax. I used 1x6s for the lower shelf boards. I had to cut out some notches with the jigsaw to make them fit around the steel members. I screwed the shelf boards to the base. I prioritized flexibility and versatility, so that's why I really wanted this split top style workbench. I left a 3.5 inch wide gap in between the two different bench tops, and then cut and planed some pieces of 4x4 to create spacers that could fit in this gap. I screwed some pieces of 2x4 to the underside of these 4x4s so that they won't slide within the frame. For the middle shelf, I just used a short piece of 2x8. This shelf will hold the steel channel when I'm not using it. And the 4x4 spacers can be easily removed to create this nice gap down the top of the workbench. I can have a nice 30 inch wide worktop. Bring up the steel channel to create an anvil or a welding table. The gap allows me to run cables or hoses through it, or clamp boards down to the center of the bench top. Now, this isn't a typical workbench, so I'm not sure how much interest there will be in it, but if you want to see plans for this on my website, let me know in the comments section below. If you want to see what I'm working on next, or follow along with my live blogging of the class I'm taking with the University of Phoenix, be sure to follow me on Instagram. Check out some of our other videos, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you haven't already. Thanks, bye.